So in today's video, I'm gonna show you how to be able to stream horizontally and vertically at the same time utilizing OBS Studio. This is gonna allow you to be able to stream to Twitch and TikTok, or Twitch and YouTube Shorts, or even YouTube and YouTube Shorts at the same time. So the very first thing you're gonna see inside of OBS Studio, this is what we're gonna create. We're gonna need to get this vertical plugin installed in our OBS Studio to be able to go ahead and do this. And again, everything that I'm mentioning today will be in the description of this video. So the first step is to come to atom.tv, and we're gonna get the vertical OBS plugin. Once you select download vertical, you'll be brought to a screen just like this. It's gonna automatically download. And then what you wanna do is you wanna open up that file that just went ahead and downloaded. You then are gonna go ahead and follow the installation steps, and then you're gonna be all set. And then you want to reopen OBS, and you should see the plugin working correctly. So once you've gone ahead and done that and you've reopened OBS Studio, if you don't see the vertical plugin here on the right-hand side, you're gonna wanna come to the top and select docs, and you wanna make sure you have vertical, vertical sources, and vertical scenes selected, and then you should be able to have a window just like this, minus the cameras if you don't have them set up yet. So the first thing we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna want to go ahead and create our scenes and our overlays that we're gonna wanna utilize on our stream. Now, for this example here today, I'm gonna utilize a stream overlay pack from streamdesigns.com, and they have tons of animated overlays you can go ahead and choose from, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. But the example I'm gonna utilize today is gonna be the Royal package here, which is inspired by Fortnite, and this is going to give me everything that I need for my stream. So we're going to see here that we're going to be able to go ahead and have our starting soon scene. We're going to be able to have our countdown timer. Everything that we need to make our stream look professional will be included in this pack. And again, you can go ahead and get one from streamdesigns.com. Now, once I have my overlay pack, I'm going to come back here to OBS Studio. And I'm going to go ahead and start by adding my starting soon. So to be able to do that, what I'm going to do is on my horizontal scene, I'm going to hit start. I'm going to come to sources, and then I'm going to select a media source. I'm going to name this media source 2. And then it's going to ask you to locate the file where you have your starting soon overlay. If you went ahead and got your overlay pack from streamdesigns.com, you're going to get your overlays in a zip file just like this. If you're on Windows, you're gonna right click and extract the file, and that's gonna create a folder here for you. If you're on Mac, you will go ahead and double click it, and it's gonna create a folder for you. Once you have that folder, you're gonna come to overlay scenes, and you're gonna select starting soon, you'll select open, and then you wanna select loop, and now you'll see here that you'll have your starting soon available there for you to be able to utilize. Now what we want to do is we want to make sure that this is also on our vertical scene here as well. So we'll click on this little plus icon on the vertical scenes, and we'll name this starting, press okay, and that's going to give us a brand new canvas here. So I'm going to select okay. On the vertical sources, we're going to hit this little plus icon. We're going to come to where it says scenes, and now here you can select the scene that we just went ahead and created, start. And then we'll go ahead and adjust this. Now, what I like to try to do is make it as big as I possibly can without getting the text cut off. And sometimes I'll have it here at the bottom, especially for my starting soon there. So next, what I'll do is that what I like to do is the countdown timer is here on the left-hand side. So what I like to do, and this is also from the same pack from Stream Designs, I'm gonna come to back to my start, and I'm gonna go ahead and add here on my vertical scenes, I'm gonna hit plus, I'm gonna hit media source, and I'm gonna come to where it says here scenes, and I'm gonna look for my count timer, and you're gonna see here that I have it here as well. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and size this up, and I'm just gonna place this right where it needs to be. Now the beautiful thing here that I'm gonna be able to do is that if you right click here on the starting sources and you see linked scene, I'm now gonna link this to start. And what that means is that whenever you switch your scenes on your horizontal stream, it's gonna automatically switch into your vertical scene as well. So let's go ahead and see what that looks like. So right now we have just me, right? So when I'm on my horizontal and I click start, you're gonna see here that now it changed on both sides. So now we wanna go ahead and create our gameplay scene. So we have our gameplay scene here where I have my game, I have my webcam overlay from the same pack I got from Stream Designs, and then me in the center. So what I wanna do is I wanna create a scene here for the vertical to be able to utilize. So I'm gonna come to vertical scenes, I'm gonna hit the plus icon, I'm gonna name this gaming scene 1, I'm gonna press okay. And now what I want to do is I want to go ahead and hit this little plus icon, and I'm going to come to where it says media source, and I'm going to go ahead and go to video capture device. I'm going to add my gameplay because I use a capture card. If you game directly on your computer, you can do a window capture. Now I'm going to go ahead and size this. Now most people like to go ahead and make this as big as they possibly can, and this is just going to cut off a lot of the scene for you. So what I like to do is I actually like to go ahead and try to keep it as horizontal as I possibly can, kind of in the center, while still giving me enough view for people to be able to see. I'll have that there, and then I'll keep it there. And remember, here at the bottom, there's going to be a lot of chat going on. There's going to be comments. It's going to be just a whole bunch of stuff distracting. So you can fill this up. And I typically like to fill it up with maybe another camera angle, or you can just go ahead and extend this if you truly desire, right? So I'm just going to leave it there. And now what I want to do is that I want to go ahead and place my camera at the top. So I'm going to come to vertical sources. I'm going to hit this little plus icon, video capture. I'm going to select my camera. And again, it's going to be here at the top. I'm just going to go ahead and size it. And now I'm going to place it there. So now I have my gameplay and I have my camera. So what I want to do again is I want to right click linked scenes. And now I'm going to go to gaming scene. And again, here you're going to see here, it's just me. So the just me, let's link this to the just me here, right? So now I have my just me talking. I can go to my start. I have my start. I have my countdown timer here as well. And then I have my gaming scene here as well. So you can see how easy this is to be able to do this. Now we need to go ahead and set up our settings to be able to send this vertical stream either to TikTok or to YouTube Shorts. So to be able to do that, you're going to come to the right-hand side here. You're going to select this little gear icon, and we're going to come to streaming here on the left-hand side. We're going to name this YouTube because we're going to stream to YouTube Shorts. Okay, and then we want to hit enable, and we want to get our server information and our key. So to be able to do that, you're going to come to YouTube, log into your YouTube channel account. You'll hit this little crate icon. We'll hit go live. And if you've never gone live before, this is going to say you have to wait 24 hours to be able to get a stream key. If you have streamed before, you'll be brought to a window just like this. Welcome to the new YouTube live control. We'll go ahead and select right now, hit start. We want to do streaming software, hit go. And now we'll be brought to a dashboard just like this. We're then going to come to where it says streaming URL. We'll go ahead and hit copy. Come back here to OBS Studio, paste the server URL. We'll come to where it says key, go back to YouTube. We'll go ahead and grab our stream key. We'll copy it there. And then we'll go ahead and come back to OBS. And then we'll go ahead and paste that there. And now for the video bit rate, you want to make sure you select at least 6,000. What I like to do is do 9,000. Now, the easiest way to be able to determine what you can put here, if you can afford to put 9,000 for the actual video bit rate, is you want to go to speedtest.net, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. You hit go, and then it's going to tell you your download and your upload. If your upload is more than 20, then you're 100% able to utilize 9,000 as the video bit rate. Keep in mind, you have a vertical stream and a horizontal stream going at the same time. So you got to keep that in mind as well, that you're going to use double the bandwidth. So again, you may want to go ahead and use 6,000 here, and then 6,000 for Twitch, if that's where you're going to be sending that over here too. So what I like to do is say use main OBS settings, and then I press OK. And now we have our vertical stream set up, ready to go to YouTube Shorts. Then here for a horizontal stream, you want to come here to where it says settings, and then you want to select output or stream. And then here's where you'll select where you want your horizontal one to go. If you want it to go to Twitch, you simply need to go ahead and connect your account, or you can use a stream key, or you can go ahead and select YouTube, and then you can do that there. Now, one of the best things is that once you go ahead and decided where you want your horizontal stream to go, and you have your vertical stream ready to go, all you need to do now is select start streaming. That's going to start your horizontal stream. And then you can go ahead and select here to be able to start streaming on your vertical. Now, if you want to know how to set up the rest of your overlays, like a just chatting scene, set up alerts, and everything you need to be able to utilize your stream overlay package, go ahead and watch this video right here, where I walk you step by step on setting up all your overlays inside of OBS Studio to make your stream look professional. I'll see you guys in the next video.